What up? I'm back. I'm back. Today is October 4th. The day before the 5th. Who cares? Who cares? Who cares what day it is? Every day is your day. Like, literally. Like, what do you want to be? Do you want to be suffering? Do you want to be crying? Do you want to worry about this? Do you worry about that? Lights getting shut off. Cars getting repoed. But you gotta go to work. You gotta feed your family. Number one priority. Survival. Stay breathing. Trust me, you know I know. And I know as long as possible. Trust me, I know. Winter time is cold, it's cold. And I find it hard to express. So I'm writing the shit on notes. I just put my feet. Those were the old days. Now it's just pleasure, 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 pleasure. And I love it. It's fun. I'ma hide you. Trust me, they can't find you. But you're making nothing but pleasure bots. And then I like it. It's fun. But there's gotta be that balance, bro. Like, you gotta have balance. Guys wanking your meat every night. Like, I mean, I like it too, bro. Spending hours getting lost in the screen. Waiting for the perfect fantasy. I trust myself. I'm not happy about what's fixing to happen. I'm not happy. Pride and ego. Women nowadays thinking that they're nothing but what their physical qualities are, and I like it. I like it a lot. I really do. However, you're not just a piece of tits and ass. Like, I don't understand. I don't understand. I was going through the day today and I was just thinking about, like, in all reality, like, without a spiritual, emotional connection, like, intimacy, like, what's the point? I don't, like, you know, this is for entertainment purposes only. If you're a child, please turn this off. Please. Put your kids to bed. But it's like, I get it. I honestly get it. I love it. But it's like, every act that I do, there's gotta be a point. There's gotta be a point. Like, in my head, it's like, my fears are wasting time. I only have so much time. Even on a scale of infinity, you only have an infinite amount of time. How long is that? Is it enough? There's never enough time. There's never enough time. So don't waste it. Don't waste it. Every second of every day is for something. It's for a reason. What is that reason? Trust me, I know. Winter time is cold, it's cold. And I find it hard to express. So I'm writing the shit on notes. I just put my feelings into the music. For experience. I wanna steal your soul now. The object of the game is to get as much experience as possible in the time that you're allotted.
And now I know what to do now.
It's bigger than you.
Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know what I'm saying?
It's so much bigger than you.
I'm glad that I got me a Pisces. With water you put me out and I keep you grounded.
That's but at the same time, it's not. Because you are the big. That is you. And you are the so much as well.
Trust me when I see straight through. We're having a minor dispute. You walk in the room and the shit's so rude. You know that we're stuck like glue.
But this is the greatest arena of all. But why? Because of the rules. Because of the limitations. But it's hard. It's very difficult. Because emotions are fucking real. And when you hurt, oh man, do they hurt. I don't know what's worse. Getting kicked in the nuts. Or understanding now that, like, pride and ego is the most difficult test of all. Because you have to flirt the line. With your divinity. And as you go through life, it's like you know you're divine. Like you know. But you run. You don't think you are. You don't think you are those things. You don't look at yourself as perfect. But what happened is when you come into this world, you're blinded. And even though you come through that womb and you are birthed into another existence, and you're fully engulfed in love, as you start to grow, there's a combative ideology against what love really is. And that's the world. That's just the world. That's people. It's not the animals. It's not nature. Those laws are those laws.
Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know what I'm saying? Yo. I'm glad that I got me a Pisces.
They're not good, they're not bad, they're just right. But as humans are so filled with pride and ego, that it's just like that's chaos and the madness, I guess you would say. Like, that's the thing. That's the start of it all. And it's like, I don't know where it comes from. Like, I don't know where it stems from. I mean, I could see where you would find your divinity. And you could harness it for pleasures of the world. But like I said, if I am pointing out that, you know, as much as I love him, it's like with another human being, like if it's not, like if we're not connecting spiritually, like, and we're just bumping ugly, it's like, to me, it's just like, I don't get it. Because I don't want to waste time. And any moment I have with humans technically is not a waste of time, but it's like, if my goals and my understanding of what I am and what I'm going to, then it's like, I'm not playing by these rules anymore. I'm not playing to this low-level logic of it's just a darker way of life. Because it's like, if you use your body as a... as a weapon. That's kind of what it is. You're just incapacitating people and then taking their energy. And it's like, it's fine, they're freely giving it to you. It's a give and take. But it's like, you're staying just in one limited belief of who you are. Like you only using your physical attraction, and then I guess your words and some other stuff, but your allure. And it is an energy, it's a sexual energy, but it's the lowest. It's down closest to the ground. Like, your sexual energy is strong, but it's like, you got so much more. Like, why are you only using 1%? Why? That makes zero sense. But there's the trade-off there. It's like, you can learn these lower level things and how the world works, and you can use those. And they're fine, and you're gonna figure your way through it, but you're always gonna be empty. You're always gonna be chasing a void. And so instead, you just get hooked at continuing to do the things that you do. And it's not bad, it's not good, but there are real repercussions based on the rules of the world. I can heal those things, but I'm not. You built your world. I can't run around the world and just impregnate the world with no STDs. It's not gonna happen. You made this, so you gotta deal with it. It sucks. But, and STDs are just, your immune system is fighting off energy from another human being. And, it's like, your physical body is only a percent of it. You don't understand. And it's like, when you guys are in the puzzle piece that's made to go together, like, it's a big deal. It's not something you just literally shake your stick at. Like, the intertwining of two existences is crazy. And it's like, you don't understand what you're doing. And we look at it as a joke, and it's not a joke. It literally brings life. It's the greatest thing in the world. It has and harnesses the most power. Like, how do you... It works. The sperm is the most powerful thing in the world. And we waste it. And it's difficult not to. It's not easy. It's not an easy task. It gets easier. A lot of times I don't like to talk about it because I get triggered. But it's like, it's life, that's life force itself. And then the female has to receive it. And then with their powers combined, they create a new life over 9 months in a womb, inside its own existence. The human process is crazy. It's freaking crazy, man. And it's like, we just take it for granted. And we just, whatever, to each his own, dude. I love it. I love it. But it's like, it's so hard to... And that's where you find the balance. And that's what I'm saying. It's like, I've just always had a set of something on me. A set of morals or understanding. And understanding that if anger is part of the darkness, which is fine. It's like, I've already been angry and it seems pointless to me. There are reasons to have it. But it's like, if I was... Okay, this is the way I see it. As long as I harnessed it, it was fine. As long as I kept it to myself and had rules and regulations, like, it was fine. But, like, in my logic, I was like, dude, if I project this anger on outside of me, like, it only turns off bad. Now, if I didn't give a fuck about anyone and their feelings, then I could say in my head, well, then fuck them. Like, I gain power over them by being angry. And it's just because in my head, it's like, well, I'll manipulate you with anger. And I will control your emotions, and then therefore I will take your soul. And it's like, I don't want any part of that. It makes zero sense. Like, they're divine, not divine, like, we are equal. this game is difficult. If I can help people through the game, because this game is fucking difficult. But I'd rather help them and give them some of me. I'm fine. I can handle it. I know who I am. Maybe I'm stronger. Maybe I'm lucky. Maybe I had a different set of tasks. Maybe I came in with a different set of knowledge. Maybe I'm just different. I mean, they're my brother. They're my sister. They're the same as me. And even if I'm not the older one or the younger one, it doesn't really matter. But in my reality, if you are there, you're there. You're mine. You're part of me. And so I'll help. I'll give you energy. I'll give you good things. I'll take your bad. I'll trick you. Plus, like, the darkness for me is regular. It's regular for me. It's not good. It's not bad. Regular. I can partake in the dark when I want to partake, and I can step out when I want to step out. It's finding balance. And as long as you have some rules and regulations in place where you don't infringe on someone's free will, whatever it is that you into and you do, like, it, you're doing it to yourself. And so you just have to justify it, and to each his own. This is for entertainment purposes only. But in that mix, you do have to remember, like, once you do birth somebody or create life, or you surrender to somebody, or you give them a bond, or you want a marriage with them, or you want a lifetime with them, like, you need to hold your obligations up. It's just, because otherwise, what's the point of saying anything in all things? It's like there's rules of the world. They're just very basic, and it's just, it's like if you don't, yeah, you can get power. You can get money, you can get women, you can get whatever you want. But it's like, you're still gonna have a void. So the issue is, like, just trying to manage how to fill that void. I mean, the void itself is you. There you go. I didn't know that. I had to go through the whole process of trying to figure out all this stuff on my own. I had help, I guess. I had pushed in the right direction. I literally just surrendered to my feelings. Like, in all reality, how do I feel? Not think about the equation itself, but just how do I feel? Not overcomplicate things with my stupid human logic. Instead, just feel with all of me. I mean, I trust it. Dude, I don't understand it, but I trust it. Because it's me. And you look at yourself and you're like, dude, how do you just trust yourself? Like, you're in there creating art, and I don't even know what it is. This video I haven't watched yet. I have no idea what it is. Who knows? Who knows what it says? I can only see a little bit of stuff. Based at my perception. So the camera angle itself, when it's panned out, that's the position that needs to be seen at. My art. And not really, it's multi-dimensional. All my art is multi-dimensional. Every bit of it. It's many scenes on top of scenes. It's also, like, the video itself is part of the art piece. Like, I'm part of the art piece. My shadow is part of the art piece. All of it is art. It's life. It's in my bubble. In my energy signature field. And I have the biggest. But I've done the work to get the biggest. And so my whole room is encapsulated with my energy. Only. I got some buddies, maybe, I don't know. But for me, it's mine. It's my space. I don't know, man. I was thinking today, like, just like, I gotta get a space, man. I gotta get out of that vicinity and get some. I gotta build it and get a paint booth. And I need, my lights, my paint. I need lights in the right direction. I need room to work. I need fan system to pull that stuff straight out of the room. Hey, yo, Pluto. You going brazen? You know, just be perfect. somewhere where I could blare some ass music, man, and go live. Just paint.
Yo,
and,
I ain't never had a go like this. Roll to the chorus, bro.
Like I said, it's a little different too. Like when I can feel the percussion of music. And not just in my ear, dude. It's even more intensified because I feel it. And I'm almost like I'm combating it, but then I roll it and I flow with it and I accept it. As me. As I am it. And it's in my world. It's part of me. You know, I kind of look at that like with humans. It's like when you're in my world. And we can break this down into many things. Like in the world itself and then in my world, which is my existence, knowledge. And then even from there, it's even closer. Like in my presence or in my protection or in my care or in my love or in my attention. Like it's a different thing. It's all things. It's all of me. Because what's the point if it's not? What's the point if it's not? And so like, I don't know, man. I had fun today, man. What did I do? I woke up and we got something to eat at Coffee Love or something. I don't know what it is. Cafe Love. It's cool. I went in there and they had art in there for sale. Like, people get to put their art up in there. I was like, cool. He's like, man, you can put your stuff up there if you want. I was like, dude. I was like, well, right now, I was like, all my stuff is 48 by. It's big. And there's no room. But it was cool. I was excited to walk in there. It's a place about adoption or by people who adopted somebody, and that's kind of the story. And then they got art in there now, and it's just like, this is awesome. And it's 101. The address is 101. And 101's it's a lot for me. So 101 has the best places. 101 is where my favorite people are. Where my favorite person is. I don't know, man. You get weird energy from people, and it's so weird. Like, you just don't understand it. But I think, like I said, I know I connect to pain, and I know I connect to my sound. And so, like, if I was to break down my sound, it would just be pain, absent of humans. Even in the presence, but, like, just overall, probably absence of humans. Like, feeling like the black sheep in the family, middle child type, different, just never accepted, just always alone, and whether that's bad or good, it's nothing, but it's like never really truly receiving what love was, or what it was supposed to be, never seeing that from anyone, aspects of love, yeah, but just never full, complete, you know, safety and security in another human being, and it's like, you look at divorce, man, and divorce is fucked up, bro. Because, like, that moment that someone has to break it to you, like your parents, one of your parents has to say, we're getting a divorce, and it's like, that moment, we can do nothing but for the first time turn our eyes on ourselves. And, like, as soon as you do that, you're a little child, and you're like, well, what the fuck did I do wrong? You know, because I've been focusing on you guys for so long. And just, you know, like, what did I do? Did I not focus on you enough? Did I not show you enough love? Did I not win the state tournament? Did I not shoot enough goals? Like, my room, I'll clean my room. I'll make my bed every day. I'll get straight A's. And then, like, but then it's like, you're just so fucked up because you're like, it's me. Grades start slipping, you start acting out, trying to get attention. You're in between who's good, who's bad, who's right, who's wrong. My dad did this, but I love him. But then, now I hate him. It's like I never saw mom do anything bad, but maybe she did, I don't know. She's here. She's hurting. She doesn't deserve that. That dude's a monster. Since everybody sends her a check before he even takes his money, like, but he's doing good, he's still being good, but look at this. Look at this. gotta go through this, gotta do that. Fucking don't have time. Sister acting this way, brother acting this way. He's trying to take the pain away. Trying to make everything better. Try not to be the fucking problem. Have to become self-sufficient because, like, there's... Because no one just has time. No one has time. Like, she's fucked up. She's hurting. She's doing well. She's holding it. She's strong. But you can only hold that stuff back for so long, and you're tired, bro. You're tired. And in a moment of weakness, you see the light. Because you quit focus on holding everything back. Yeah, it made sense when you were a child. Because what happened was, your focus on a happy life, on two parents, on a mom and dad, always having someone there for you, your focus is fucking gone. And all you can focus on is the pain. All you can focus on is the not knowing. What did I do? What did I do? What can I do? Like, because I can't control anyone else. And like, you roll back into like this primitive brain of like, but it's good. It kind of shows you the way, but it shows you that ultimately you're not in control of other people. But that's the problem. For a brief minute, you understand you're not in control of anyone, and then your pride ego says, "Yes, I am." And then you live a life to do that. You could become a helper, you could become a narcissist, it doesn't matter. It just depends on you. And it's not, one's not better than the other. They're just a real repercussions to both. You know? And it's like the narcissist way is more of external repercussions on other human beings. And you're like, just fuck it, I don't care. And then the helper is like, well, external. Like, you do things and it all comes back on you because you're used to being the problem. So you actually like being the problem. You want to be the fucking problem. And it's like, because at least you fucking get attention. And you learn, like, that negative attention is good attention. And it's like, you start to become engulfed in, like, that weird manipulation of helping humans. But it's like, it's really a way of you just controlling them. And, it's real weird to say it that way because it's like you would look at it like a victim, but it's like this is why I'm saying I'm taking my power back. It's because like everything that I did for anyone always it was always my choice, and there's not wrong with being a helper. Like I still love helping people, but it's like you are creating your own scenario. Like you really are, and you're not defending yourself because you don't think you're worthy of anything. You don't even look at yourself at all, other than like. It goes back to the physical traits. So, like, I would use my body to get what I needed, which was love and attention and money and whatever else. Like, that's what I thought all I was. I didn't know that I was so much more. I just used one aspect of life, just like someone who thinks that they're attractive and uses that to get their way. I never thought I was attractive. I don't know. I never looked at myself. I knew I wasn't worthy of time growing up, and then so I just transferred that over to just the way of life, and I didn't understand it. But I mean, I would use my skills, my mind. That's why I talked the other day about pain and how I would use pain to instantly learn things, because I had to try and escape the pain. So I had to be super smart, and I had to learn things, and as I said, I used to just believe in the tangible, and so therefore, like, what I tangibly could do for you was my worth. And then, you know, when you come out of that and you're like, dude, I'm worth everything already, dude. I'm fucking fire. And it's like, yeah, I do have skills based on this whatever exchange, and then you get money. But it's like money is pointless. Because like I said, it wraps all the way back around to time. Like time is important, and then your vessel is important. Like without either one of those things, you don't exist. So it's like on a scale of hierarchy or a 1-2-3 list, like those things have to be first. Like money is nothing. Like you could go without food for a while, you can go without water for a while. You can start drinking from a creek, you can do whatever the fuck you want. Like you'll be fine for a while. Like you'll find food. Dig through trash cans, do what you gotta do, man. Like if you're that hungry. It's not right, it's not wrong. You know, and if that's the way of life you choose, that's cool. I mean, honestly, you're kind of ahead of the curve. But at the same time, what are you comfortable with? You're controlling your world. Do you want to be homeless? Do you want to be cold at night? Or do you want some amenities? And so you just gotta justify your life. And it's like, there's no right or wrong way to do this other than just trying. You don't infringe on other people's free will. These are the laws that we need back. You don't fucking touch nobody. It's kind of weird. I'm still trying to learn the hug thing. I don't. Or the touching people. Like, I went through life without touching people. And so for me, it's like, it's something that I need to learn. And I understand a lot of times that it is appropriate, but a lot of times it's not. And it's like, but that's just my logic. It doesn't mean that someone else doesn't think it's appropriate. You know, go to town, do what you got to do. But I just weird. I'm still trying to learn these boundaries and like not infringing somebody's free will because it was just ingrained in me. And so, you know, like I said, that right there alone holds me back a lot of times because it's like, as assertive as I am, I was like, I have these rules and regulations where I cannot force myself on someone, even if it's warranted. Like, it has to be, I don't know, pursued or accepted or, you know, a gesture or a whatever. Like, because this is like, people touched me growing up that I didn't want anything, I don't want them to touch me. They did anyways. And so like in my head, it's that. It's me trying to show respect for just brothers and sisters and whoever, just other human beings. Like, ask. Because no one asked me. And it fucked me up. Like I said, man, I understand that I was a difficult human being. And I understand that I had the superpower of invisibility. And I had a way of pushing my energy and backing people up and making them stay away from me. I was good at it. But everything I do, I master. A jack of all trades is a master of none. Slapping a movie on come less chill. I remember the day that I met you. No way could I ever forget that. I would go back home with a deal. I master everything. I'm texting bro like yo. E-man texts me back like wild one. Because otherwise, what's the point? What's the point? And I look at my life and I understand it's like, you know what? There's a lot of stuff that you got to give it time. But it's like, now as you learn. And kind of when I say master, maybe I'm not the best. But I'm the best that when I walk away, I'm okay with it. And so, like, that's the justification in my head. It's like, when you understand you try to live your life on perfection, and then you understand that there's literally no fucking point in perfection because I'm not getting paid enough for perfection. Meaning, it's not equaling out my time. Yeah, it's a means to an end right now, but it's like, that means nothing. That's just, I'm stuck in between two worlds that I created, and I have to deal with my own karma and repercussions. And that transition period was that. Have to do the greatest task in the world while dealing with your karma. That's what everyone's going through. I just put my head in the dirt and went, bro. And complete surrender. Complete send. It definitely made it easier to take away all your choices and to cry about it. I cried for a while, you know, trying to go to work and finish things, and then finally just one day it clicked. It was like, fucking just go finish the job, bro. It's never going to get done like this, and you're going to be stuck in this window of time for all of eternity. Until it's done, until this fated event is done, like, you're never going to move on. It's you're just dragging it on. However, you are playing the game in a pretty damn intelligent way. Because you could have finished it earlier and left, but you would not have been as high level as you are now. And so I look at it like video games where, like, there's a fated event that happens, and you know what's going to happen if you played the game, and you know that that's your next place to go. But you can choose to go around the world and fight other bosses and level yourself up, you know. And that's what I chose to do, because it's the smartest thing for me to do on the scale of time. Because it's like, if I'm stuck in the old world with the old abilities, like, if I was to leave now, it's going to be way more difficult for me with old skills that I'm still trying to grow from. So it's like, it sucks and I have to be patient. But it's like, I just need to keep leveling up as long as I possibly can. And just allow the best time and move on to happen when it's supposed to happen, when the best time is coming. And when everything falls into place without me pushing it and forcing it. And me to just surrender to the process and surrender to the understanding that I just want to keep leveling up. I have so much more work to do that it's going to be better to do it now. And be ready to do it before and have to go through some trials and tribulations because you didn't take the time to prepare for what you was walking into. And so, like, now I'm more well equipped to walk into whatever and be able to finish it, fix it, help, especially my partner. Like, that's to me, it's like, if I wasn't ready, and there was a chance that I could fuck her up and leave her and abandon her and all that shit. Like, it's like, it was worth the patience for me to make sure that I knew that everything I'm dealing with, my addictions, my desires, my weaknesses, my strengths, like, my understanding, my communication skills, like, If they weren't right, then there was no point. It would have been pointless, and then I would have hurt someone that I love. I don't like that. I don't like it at all. I was hurt so much, dude. It's fucked up from someone who was supposed to love me. Over and over again for all fucking all the time. People supposed to love me, and then in return, I get hurt. But it is what it is. I mean, a lot of that's self-inflicted. I'm not the victim. There were lessons for me to grow, so I wouldn't feel that shit again. That's what emotion is. Feel it. Learn about it. Choose if you want to feel that shit again. If you don't, then don't do shit that makes you feel that way. And then again, sometimes we love it. We listen to sad, somber music. Listen to breakup music, and it feels so fucking good. The pain is just right. And for a second, you can just accept it and be like, yeah, they get me. They felt it too. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. I'm not the only one in time who's felt this. We all feel it. Love is crazy, man. I don't even understand it. Especially, like, just on that level, like, it's weird, like, you look at your life and you're just like, you've literally just been alone, man. It's not good, it's not bad, but it's like, it's like, because you look at the amount of experiences you have, and then, like, you have zero. And it's like, dude, to be so skilled in so much more stuff, like, this is the pride and ego battle, it's like, you know nothing. You know nothing. And it's like, I texted this guy today because I bought this little drum mat and some drums and sticks, and I told him I was like a ready teacher. But that's what you have to come as, like a student in all life. It's to get the max potential, you have to be the student always. You always have to be willing to open up your mind and just listen. You don't have to accept. You get to choose. You're the ruler. You're the king of yourself. But you should always be willing to listen. Because they have a different set of experiences than you. Like, you cannot deny that. Therefore, their information is different than yours. And so the way that they choose an answer could be totally different. Based on all the information that they have to solve that equation with. But then again, there's basic laws that kind of beat that, but that's just for one experience. But. I don't know, man. I went to that place, and then what did I do? I ate, and then I went to the park. I had fun, dude. I had so much fun at the park, bro. Listened to a talk. Maybe twice. And, I was just like, whatever. I need the rest. I'm tired. And, I thought about going home earlier today and like, taking a nap, but I didn't. And, so everything happens exactly the way it's supposed to. So I went, I listened to my talk, and then, I like to hang out with my trees a little bit. Like, these little things are fun to walk on. These timbers, they're fun to walk on, so I walk on those and just listen to my music, man. And these birds were dancing. I was going to take my camera out and videotape them, but I just watched them with my eyes. And I said, some things are for me. And I just listened to my talk, played Floor's Lava. That's always so fun, and it's very tiring. A lot of stuff that I do is so multifaceted. It's like, if I'm doing this act, I know I'm getting multiple benefits from it. You know, and it's like, dude, if I'm flexing, if I'm playing Floor's Lava, and I'm walking across these rock heads that are just sticking out, and I try and just keep my foot on them all the way to the other side and back and whatever, just whatever I feel like doing, it's fun. You know, and you kind of move to the music a little bit, you know, because the music's playing in my talk, and so it's like you're just kind of encapsulated in the moment of yourself. You're giving yourself time. You're playing a game. You know, it's flexing all those muscles in your legs and your calves, so like you're working out your calves and all that shit. You're balancing here. You're actually kind of over-exaggerating your movements to make it harder and more difficult, but yet more fun. And then you just play the Floor's Lava. And it's fun, dude. You just get lost in the moment that you create, and it's like your imagination is the thing that keeps you happy when you're alone. Because the imagination is you. And I was out there, and I've been watching my shadow a lot more today. Because I'm just understanding this, like, what are you? Are you the person? So I took a picture, and I took a picture of my shadow. And it's like, are you, like, what are you? Who are you in this? Are you the shadow? Are you the human behind the camera taking the picture? Are you the light version that's in the light, in the sun? Are you what is being bounced off of you, blocking out the sun? The shadow. The skin. What's contained inside of you. That's what is projecting out of you. The sun is, you're a prism. And the sun is producing, light is producing something off of you. That's real. It's just lack, it's like no light. Because you're sucking up all the light. Because you are light. Front side of the moon. Front side of the sun. Maybe, who knows? I've never seen the back side of the moon. Ever. I've been here a long time. You're sucking up all the light. It's weird, like I'm just thinking about front side and back side. Things grow to the sun. Front side and back side. So like the concept to me, this is what is coming into my head, is love. Or light. It would be light and darkness. So if you give someone the front side, what are you? What are you doing? You're dealing with love. Light. If you give someone your backside, what are you doing? You're dealing with darkness. Deception even. You're walking away, you're not giving light, you're not giving love. You're turning your back on. You're not being able to look into each other's souls. You're not being able to connect spiritually. Completely, at least. But it's still there. And so it's just like, it's the balance. It's the double-sided coin. It's two sides to everything. And it's like the light version, the version that is getting the sun, and then the backside, you know. And it's not. And it's like in the totality of things, is it wrong? Is it needed? Like, you gotta have both in the system that we've created. So then it's just almost like, but it's like, what do you want? That's the point. It's like, what do you choose? And it's like, well, there's good things about the dark. Like, there's power there. And manage right, you'll be able to harness and use that energy. And then in the light, it's the same. There's good things there, you know, whatever. And it's like, so in my brain, it's like, well then, if I'm strong enough in myself and I can set limits, then it's like you can go light and dark every time. Like, it, you're able to be both. Like, you think of Star Wars and it's like the light and the dark. It's like, but well, why would you just be one? Like, it makes zero sense. This is why it makes zero sense. It makes zero sense because you guys are trying to do it based on laws that you're given by man. And when you understand that there's higher laws, when you look at things with a higher perspective, it means you can reshape and do things differently based on your laws, because you're your own king. And you can justify what you're doing. Yes, there's still laws in the world that you cannot pass. And some of them are good. Like, let's not beat each other up. Let's not abuse each other. So on and so on. But it's like, I set limits before those limits could even get acknowledged. Like, it's very simple. Don't infringe in someone's free will. Like, it's very simple how much stuff just disappears out of your life. When you don't infringe in someone's free will, when you don't lie, when you don't manipulate, and you don't force. You don't, you know, alternative motive them. You just do. So
one night, slap in a movie and come, let's chill. I remember the day that I met you.
Yeah, based on the world standards, you may not get what you, you know, if you're not forceful. But it's like, why would I want that if I have to work for it? I don't want it. Makes zero sense. I don't want it bad enough to work for it. Because if I have to work for it like that, it's not love. Like, I want it given to me. Like, it's hard to explain. It's like freely. I want someone to freely make the choice. I'm not going to trick you. I don't want to manipulate you. I'm just being me. And either you want it or you don't. Either you like it or you don't. I could care less. I can't forcefully, like, manipulate and trick and sweet talk and all this shit. Man, you can't do that. It's not... I mean, I guess if it's real, but it's like, to me, it's not real because it's not Cody. And I have these rules and regulations in place. It's just like, if I do any of that stuff, then to me, it just feels like if I don't say the truth, then I feel weird. Like, I can't do it. I guess I can. I just don't... What's the point? Like, because if I'm lying to you, then I'm lying to me. I don't want to lie to me. I like me. I love me. Like, why would I lie to myself? It doesn't mean you don't... You're not trying to work things out in your head. I will say that. Because with new information, as time goes on, I'm trying to just justify the real... A higher perspective understanding of the rules. And what's okay and what's not okay. Like, what's too far and what's not too far. And, But mostly, it's not even, a lot of it may not even really be for me right now. Maybe in the long term it will be for me, but a lot of it is just for the world itself. And it's like, I'm trying to understand, like, what has to be implemented and what is okay. Because it's a confusing time in humanity. And it's like, I think with programming, of TV and music and Instagrams and the TikToks and the news, it's like, what are we doing, like, in our reality? And it's like, what is really okay? Like, I understand that I don't know, man. It's kind of confusing. I'm just trying to figure it out, because, like I said, remember, I'm looking at everything in the totality, and it's like, in the totality of everything, everything is technically okay. Because it all has to be counterbalancing itself. But it's like, the world that I want to create, the world that I have created. It's different. So it's just like trying to find the rules that go within that difference. Because, like, put it this way, like, if procreation is needed, then you look at other stuff and you're like, everything's okay, but we still have to procreate, you know? And you look at societies, like the Greek society or whatever, or Rome or whatever, and it's like, it's weird, like, when sexuality controls the nation. In which, right now, it does. Look at it in any way, whether it's... Yes, the sexuality of, like, yeah, just that, the whole thing encapsulated, just in general. And it's like, it's not good or bad, it's just how we express our sexuality and just the lack of self-control. And then it's like, we understand that we can't just... We still gotta procreate. You know, maybe there needs to be a time where we don't procreate at all, and then we just deal with adopted kids and orphanages, and then go from there, and then maybe we can start procreating again after that. I don't know. But it just depends. It depends on what happens in the near future. But so it's just like, whatever. I don't know. I would say everything is okay. However, we cannot detest this, that when a man and woman come together, they make a baby, or at least have the potential to do it. And so, like, you gotta think, if that's the greatest thing in the world, literally, is creating life, whether it's in the animal kingdom, whether it's the human kingdom, creating life out of nothing, like I said, we can't do that. We have to create it out of something that's coming out of the two greatest, strongest things in the world. One is an egg, which is just a harnessing with nutrients in it and DNA, mapping, coding, and then sperm, which is life, which ignites. It is an ignition. It's a spark, one spark. And so, like, you would just have to say that that has to be the greatest, because if we can't do it, two men can't come together and create a baby, and then two women as well cannot, technically. And so you would just have to say that the procreation is always got to be kept as number one, and then anything else flies, whatever, do what you want to do. But we gotta keep bringing new kids in this world. You can't, you know, and in the world in the future, it's gonna make more sense when it's safer. But I mean, these are for the new world. So I don't know. I gotta look into that a little bit more. But it is what it is. It's not good or bad. It just is. And whatever. Today was cool. I listened to my talk twice, whatever, and then Thor's Lava, and then I kind of walked. I just walked the lap, and I took some pictures in the shadows, and I haven't really looked at them. I don't really ever look at anything. I just take pictures if I feel the need to, and then I'll look back at them for a couple seconds later, and I'll go on from there. Then I left there. I went to the job just to check on it, crack some windows open, make sure it wasn't getting too fumey. And left. Got some paint. Went and ate. I really didn't want to eat. I was bored. And I was gonna get Pride and Ego tattooed on my hand, but it didn't work out. So I was pumped for it. So I guess I'm probably just gonna get a tattoo gun and do it myself. At some point, maybe. I don't know. I want Pride and Ego there, but I think I gotta do something different. I think I'm gonna do something crazy. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, that's cool, man. There's no telling. Like, I have infinite possibilities, and it's like, this infinite possibilities of life. Like, you can do anything you want to do. And, like, once you truly believe that, and it's not a fallacy, and it's not a lie, it's like, well, what do you want? You know? Like, what do you want to do with your time? And it's like, man, I want to keep creating. In every aspect. Every aspect. What you can see, what you can't see. You know, and it's like, I want to create with somebody. Not everybody. Just one. And I want to experience everything with them. Everything. When I think about me being alone the whole time, like, I'm looking back at my experiences, and it's like, I don't even know how to judge them, because I only have my perception. I only have my view. They're not good, they're not bad, it's just, but I lived my whole life in my perception. Because I was never able to surrender. Other than I walked around in my mom's, I guess, but I, like, this is a little bit bigger than that, but surrender and have safety and security in another human being that I trust and I give them my heart so they can live with it. And I can get the perception from them. I can watch them. I can learn them. I spent my whole life learning me. But now I'm ready to learn somebody else. But I want to learn somebody else completely like I learned myself completely.
And I don't know what to do now. Nah, man, I don't know what to do. Hold on, let me talk star signs.
I want to be able to flow with them. And I want them to be able to flow with me. And the only capable, only way of that is if you have complete trust, like you send it. Because I trust me. Like literally, like I trust whatever it is. Every word that comes out of my mouth. Every motion that I make. Every blink of the eye. I trust me. And I want to trust that other person. It's not that hard. They just gotta show up. And I trust you. I already do. I trust you completely. I trust that you're the beat that I want. I trust that whatever it is that you do, you do. And I can flow with you. I can't flow with everybody else. I don't want to flow with everybody else. I can flow with you. And wherever we go, we go. It's not a big deal. I did what I had to do to get here, though. And all in the name of love. Real love. No restrictions. No manipulations. No tricks. Whatever it is, it is. Whatever you was before, be mine now, right? And I'm yours? Well, who cares? It's the past. Past is the past. You get to choose who you are right now. And who you want to be from this point forward. Capable of anything, all things, the greatest actor of all time. You just gotta act. Literally. What do you want to become? Who do you want to be? Be that. Own that. And try and stay within the guidelines of not infringing in someone's free will. I don't know how to explain it. This is based on my experience. But to me, it just makes sense. Don't infringe in someone's free will. It's so much bigger than just an action of these laws that we have about, you know, assault. Like, because this has to do with, like, mental. Like I said, I think physical is 10%. What does that leave 90 in the mental? Because that's where your power is. Your body, your vessel, your meat suit. It's just a robot. And you're the controller. And if you're not controlling you, then somebody else is. And that's just ignorant. That's infringing in somebody's free will. However, you have to come strong enough to not allow people to infringe in your free will. No, that's a lot of it. That's the hardest spot. That's definitely the hardest spot. Because like you can prevent people from touching you. Like that's easy. But like, you know, and that's why you got to cut a lot of people off. It's because like, you can't stay in the same environment and expect to grow, because you're just going to be bombarded with the same thing over and over again. Like, you got to get a break. You have to get a break. You got to be able to come up for air, to breathe. So you got to cut people off. And then you kind of will be reinduced with each situation, type of person, narcissist, someone who mentally abuses you, someone who, you know, questions your worth, whatever. And they could just be different people in your life. But as you can take them in bite-sized, you know, chews, like little bitty, you can overcome and stand your ground. And you can become more confident in who you are, and you understand that you can breathe for once. And maybe the shame and guilt is off, and it's just like whatever stories, manipulation, tricks, fairy tales in your head about this and that, like you're able to walk away from it. And to start to see things a little bit more clearer. And as time goes on, the more time you give yourself, the more distance you take from the things that were breaking you or holding you back or to change you down, like, you start to get a new perspective, because those things were clouding your perspective on everything. You thought those perspectives were keen, and you adopted those perceptions as your own. Probably because you've It sounds weird, like you're almost like you're giving safety and security to other people, but you are. You're giving them safety and security in other aspects of your life. A lot of them control you with money. A lot of them control you with situations. A lot of them control you with a one-night stand and having a baby. So, like, these are the real repercussions I'm talking about. So you just gotta take your power back. You gotta do it in small bites, small increments, but you just gotta keep doing it. Consistency is key. Because every day is a new day. Meaning, no matter how bad it is today, tomorrow you wake up, it's new.
I don't know what to do now. Nah, man, I don't know what to do.
And you get to choose.
Hold on, let me talk star signs.
I talked to this woman at Hobby Lobby, and I told her, I was mad and angry for 35 years. And I said, the day that I realized that was stupid, I chose not to be that anymore. And I told, there was another woman just smiling. I saw her in my peripheral vision the whole time. Every time I said something, I'd just see her. And I said, in the totality of things, it's not that simple. Well, it actually is that simple in the totality of things. I said, but in the day-to-day, when you have a smaller number and it's a greater number of time, like, yeah, it's bigger in this, that scale, or in an hour. So, like, it'd be 90% of your time, you know. Who knows? This is a lot. But, dude, it's so fun. Because everything is such a surprise. It's like everything is such a surprise, because you're constantly learning about yourself that you ran away from your whole life. And so you're getting to relive your life in an adult body with adult money, with an adult things, freedom that you didn't have when you was a child. And so, like, it's so much more exciting this way, because I can still be a child but have freedom. No, not have ideas from my mother. Not telling me where to go. Don't jump off that. You can't do that. You can't paint on that. You can do anything you want within reason. Don't infringe on people's free will. And anything flies. Like, I think about going to the restaurant, man. My favorite place in the world, dude. And it's like, I didn't infringe on anyone's free will. They didn't infringe on mine. You know, headphones on, fucking dancing, doing weird ass shit with my hands. Like, energy just going crazy. But they just let me be. No mom, no cut it out. And I know that I hurt you one time if
I do that again, then I'm a fool. And I know that the love runs deep. Trust me, you know.
Stop that, you weird.
You really do got me. Trust me, I know. Winter time is cold, it's cold. And I find it hard to express. So I'm writing a shit.
None of that. I just put my feelings in. It's like, and then so you look back and you're like, dude, I never had that.
I wanna steal your soul now. Well, I wanna steal your soul.
Whatever I did, it was wrong.
I'ma hide you. Trust me, they can't find you.
So like, you walk in a place where like you can fucking do anything within reason. I mean, I didn't do anything crazy, but I mean, it was damn seemed crazy to me. But I didn't infringe on someone's free will. I took, evidently they just allowed me to do it. I don't fucking know, man. I don't know. But yeah, man, I appreciate everything, and it's like, you know, I don't think I was ever. I like I said, I did have the knowledge one night, like, to think about, like, how I could see how people get to the point of suicide. I think during this journey, I don't think I ever thought about it as in, like, doing it. But I did come to the realization where I can empathetically step into someone's shoes, and this is what I did, and find it okay. Like, where I could get to the point where I had zero hope. But it's like, I guess once I got tattooed on me, hope, like, there was no way I could not have hope. And I think, you know, I think tattoos are crazy because it's like, you're putting it on you for all of eternity. And I look at my arms and I see imprints of old tattoos. It's very hard for me to explain. I saw it one night and I was like, man, they look fucking cool. And and being that my art is the way it is, like, I'm understanding that I'm doing stuff and saying stuff that I don't understand with my 3D eyes here. And so it's like, I know that the shapes and stuff and letters, whatever, man, who knows what they mean. And it's not for me to find out. It's for the people to see my stuff and then it connect to them. And who knows what it means? I don't know. That's what's so crazy. That's why I trust myself so much. It's like, I full surrender to whatever is in that video.
Yo.
And then I lose time. I lose space. I just do. I don't even know what I did. I don't know what each scene's saying. I don't know any of this stuff. None. I have intuition of what it is. And I'm okay with it. I'm always okay with it. It's me. It sucks. Whatever it is, whether it's something from my past I gotta deal with, it comes up, I just have to fucking accept it. I can try to explain myself, I guess, but there's really no point. It is what it is. And it's fucking embarrassing, but it's like, I trust myself so much that I went through the game of life. I did whatever it is that I've done. And it's like, you gotta pay the piper sometimes. If you haven't yet. And so it's just like, whatever. And then you got to just understand that you are responsible for your own actions. And I think everything that in my life that's gone the way it has is exactly what it's supposed to be. It's hilarious. And it's like, because I don't know why I just have to do the hardest tasks ever. I don't get it. Other than I just have to. Like, I don't see a way of not. And it's fucking embarrassing. And I don't know. But it is what it is. But I think that's kind of the issue. It's like, some humans are strong enough to withhold themselves from things, and some people are not. And it's like, it's a self-control issue there. But it's like, you know, it's actually super weird. It's because, like, it goes back to, what do you want? Like, what do you want to do? That's what you're gonna do. Like, in every aspect. Every aspect. Once you really, and even more so now, once you start loving yourself and you're your best friend. You're your only friend, right now, at least for me. I don't have my other friend here, my best friend, whatever. But I was thinking about that too when I was looking at this shadow. I was like, dude, that dude's me. And he's always been with me. And he's always gonna be with me. Peter Pan and his shadow. But yeah, dude, it's weird, bro. It's weird. It's everything's exactly where it's supposed to be, and it's like, it's like with coming with the light and dark, right? With the good and evil, you know, whatever you want to call it, good and bad, naughty and nice. Like with coming with that, like you, like being that I'm both. It's like it's weird. It's weird what you are. Like it's weird, man. It's fucking weird. Hey, yo, Pluto. But everything happens exactly the way it's supposed to. And life is fun, man. Came home. I actually painted this one to a couple songs and ended on this one. I didn't download or I didn't do the other ones because whatever. Some of them were super quick, man. I really, honestly, today was just, I wanted to test what I would create by surrendering. And whatever it is, it is. And I don't know, man. I'm going to push the limits on that later. Today was really just trial and error, honestly, of what it was going to do. I know that in the future I'm going to need to put intentions on things and choose what I want to create, maybe the final outcome before I do it. I want to do that just for a reason, just to test myself, but I don't know, man. This journey is fun. I have no idea what that art's going to be in there. So I'm actually really excited because usually I just go in, I fix the sound, I crop, make it, and then I upload it instantly before I watch it. Then when that upload's done, I listen to that upload while I'm uploading it on like YouTube or something. And so like ultimately, I'm not even watching the movie that I put up. Like I have no idea what's going on. I have no idea what I'm putting in my art. Like zero. I know a little. I know enough. I know exactly what I did. I like to pretend I don't. It makes it easier to do. Hit the send button or whatever. And it's not even that. It's because it's a pride and ego battle, and that's what, like I said, I wanted to get pride and ego on my hands, and it's like I know how I'm gonna get them now, but it's gonna be fire, and it's gonna be perfect. And yeah, man, I don't know. I lost my train of thought. It's crazy because I'm sitting out here in the shadows and these trees just like the shadows of the trees, like it's so crazy, man. It's so crazy. But who knows, man? Who knows what's gonna happen tomorrow? I don't know, man. And I honestly, I'm still waiting to see my art because I don't even know. I haven't looked at it, so it's like I don't know. I don't. And the video is like I'm understanding. Like this video is very important because it shows everything, and it's like I don't know the scenes in between until I watch this video. Because I trust that whatever I'm making, even though it may not look like something that you think, it's something. And it's like, so I look at my art like that now. It's like, you know, it's so much more, dude. It's not about the finishing piece. It's about the process. Like the process. The creating, the act of creating. Because once you're done, you're done. It is what it is. No more, no less, no good, no bad, no light, no dark, just done. No changing. It's too late. Stages, I'm ready. I found the one. Fake accounts gonna talk their shit. Why both of us be lit? I don't really give a fuck about that. As long as the relationship is bliss, and I know that, you know, maybe I'll go back and sign my name on some of them that I haven't signed my name on. Hurt you one time. If I do that again, then I'm a fool. And I know that the love runs deep. Trust me, you know I know. And I know that you really do got me. Trust me, I know. Winter time is cold, it's cold. And maybe I'll go back and accept some things that I've created. I just put my feelings into the music. That's the way that men know. I want to steal your soul now. Why? I wanna steal your soul. And all that therefore is so I can remember when I was created. Trust me, they can't find you. This is just a product. The meat and potatoes was in the creation. In the act of preparing. In the hardships, in the failures, in the overcomes, in the goals you met. In the tears, in the sweat, in the vomits, in the blackouts. What it's about. What it's about. The heartbreaks. The gifts. The laughters. Summer songs, you know? Just music. Fucking music. The sound of eternity, man. Sound of hearing the same note for all of eternity. Yo, I ain't never had a girl like this. Roll to the chorus. Fucking crazy ass note. You never know what's gonna happen, just fucking all over the place. I might pull up on a late night one night, slap on a movie and come. Perfect. I remember the day that I met you. No way could I ever forget that. I would go back home with a DLR train, just missing the fact you left me. Piss as hell, distant. Loves you next minute. After the whole stages, I'm ready. I found the one. Fake accounts gonna talk that shit. Why? Both of us be lit. Perfect. I don't really give a fuck about that. As long as the relationship is bliss. And I know that my baby humble. But I know that your temper's short. And I know that I hurt you one time. If I do that again, then I'm a fool. Perfect. And I know that the love runs deep. Trust me, you know I know. And I know that you really do got me. Trust me, I know winter time is cold, it's cold. And I so many perfect moments, man, in my head. Into the music, that's the way that I just think about the moment you're, I wanna steal your soul now. I wanna steal your soul. You just get to set and you're watching. Trust me, they can't find you. Just the most real authentic moments in your life.
Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you see the emotion, you feel the emotion, like you are the energy and motion. And you are just engulfed. And you are just watching the greatest performance of your life. And like, like you're trying, you just fucking can't do anything else. And you're just watching every single time. Like, it's a video, dude. It's a movie. Like, I sat there and watched a human being one day. It's the most engulfing experience of my life. Like, not really. I mean, I have tons of them because this is all around one person, but like, I'm laughing inside. Like, I am laughing. I'm in amazement. I'm in awe. And just in awe. Like, and I can't fucking pull my eyes away. I just cannot do it. And this person was like fumbling with these things and like trying to put them in their place, and it was the most adorable thing I've ever seen in my life. I Like, I couldn't stop watching her hands. But at the same time, like, I see everything. So it's like, I was just, like, I couldn't pull away. And I just I was just laughing inside so hard. I was just amazed. I don't think I was ever that amazed before. Like, I was deer in the headlights. I couldn't move. And I knew that she knew. I knew that she could feel me looking. And I knew I could feel her knowing that I was looking. If that makes any sense. Like, it's hilarious. Because that made it even funnier. Because I knew that she knew. And yet she continued too. Because then I saw like the little child version of frustration. And kind of a little bit of embarrassment. But she's like, fuck it, dude. I'm so damn stubborn. And I'm like, there she is. That she is going to sit there and fumble through that shit knowing that I'm watching her. And that I know that she knows that I'm watching. And so, like, it was just a straight pride and ego battle, dude. And it was so funny and hilarious. And it was just perfection in itself. Like, it makes zero sense. Other than, like, just looking at interactions with a human being and understanding that they are so fucking profound. If you are aware of it. If you take the time to appreciate living in the now. I watched that human being, like, talk to somebody forever, and like, it was so emotional, it was hilarious. And then, like, you saw, I can't even talk, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, it was just like, she came around the thing and she was just like, so proud. And I'm gonna take her hair down, and I was like, holy shit. I'm done. To have somebody come out and just do their best to make you happy, to make you okay, in the fucking darkest emotions I've ever felt in my life. The worst. To give you hope when you barely ever had any hope in yourself.
Hey, yo, Pluto, you going brazen?
For once, you really realize you're not alone.
Yo, I ain't never had a girl like this. Roll to the chorus, bro. And I can't talk about sex every day on the track, so I talk about the shit I feel. I might give you flowers and kisses, not just dick and this shit, bro.
You're not alone. That's all I've wanted to do is fucking not let people be alone. The alarm train just missing the fact you left, man. I'm texting, bro, like, yo. E-man texts you back like Wagwan. I said, I know what it makes. I know how easy it is to be a monster. It's all by cause. It's all caused by thinking you're alone. No one cares what I do. No one cares who I be. What's the point?
I wanna steal your soul now. I wanna steal your soul.
This makes me feel good. I might as well fucking do it to the extreme. No one cares.
But now I don't know what to do. to do.
Well, I guess I gotta do this to get that. Hold on, let me talk. This is a little shady, but I mean, yo, no one fucking cares. I'm glad that I got me a Pisces. With water you put me out and I keep you grounded. That's like B. I'm so glad that your mom do like me. Got the old school love like night. Boom, get in trouble, go to prison, go to jail, whatever. No one fucking cares. I know it should be day soon. I got you when you be day boo. I know when you're upset, trust me when I see straight through. We're having a minor dispute. You walk at the room and the shit's so rude. Do you know that we're stuck like glue? And do they? Do they though? Do they fucking care? Think about it. How many people are you pick up the phone right now? And you was able to get a hold of them. I'd say that for myself, because a lot of times, like, I'll have a phone on silent. I guess I just need to keep it on, but... Like, how many people would fucking come to the edge of the earth for you? Really? Really? Because no one fucking cares. And if... You know, and that's what's so crazy. I hate to say this, but if people won't do that for you, like if you know someone's not gonna do that for you, what's the fucking point? Why would you give them your time? Why? I'll fucking burn for you. I don't know why. There's no reason. Just because. Like, there's no logic in why I'm saying what I'm saying. I'm just saying what I'm feeling. Like, in my head, I'm like, I'm trying to, like, logically think about this. Like, this makes zero sense. Like, why would you just freely burn for somebody? That makes zero sense. No point in time does that make any sense. My feelings say, because. Why not? Why not? Like, it makes, why not? Like, why would I not help you? I want to steal your soul now. I want to steal your soul. That makes zero sense. But it's almost like in my brain, this is the statement. This is what, why would I not help you? And then it reverts back to, because I want help, or I want to help you, or I would help you. And it's just like what I would do for myself. Like, it's fucking weird. My brain is crazy now because I created this. Understanding that in order to be selfless, you have to be selfish. I went to a place today, talked to a woman today. Everything happened exactly what it's supposed to. Boom. She's going to move home to her mom, who's old. I was like, dude, I was like, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. You know how long it takes for people to understand what fucking family is? And this is me. This is me going, I don't really agree with, like, they're not my family anymore, in a sense. This is me saying this. But they're not, I was alone. I created an alone system. Yes, my little brother's my little brother, my older brother's my older brother, my sister. But what I'm saying is, like, you can take it to heart if you want. Do with it what you will. It's not what it's intended. But whatever, man, I don't know. There's still stuff I need to... Yeah, I'll burn for you. But I mean, that's the whole point. It's like, if people aren't that all about you, like what are you losing? And this is me. I love everyone. But it's, I'm understanding that, like, I'll do it for one. I'll do it for one. Cause why the fuck not? Why the fuck not? Like, how is not the greatest thing you could do as a human is sacrifice your time and existence, which is fucking everything. For another human being. Every single time. Doesn't matter what side you're on. No reality. But a true sacrifice. Like in the moment of life and death, not none of this pre-programmed religious dogma. that literally just you kill each other off. I mean, it's part of the rules. It's part of what's implemented in each stage. But it's in all reality, it's like you guys are just making zero sense. However, like in scenarios where you could save a life, especially a child, infinite potential, like. Any of it, any, like, that's crazy to me. Like, it tore me up. Like, to think about the concept itself, as to give up all of your time to save one. So why the fuck not? Why the fuck not? It doesn't mean like it doesn't suck sometimes, dude. Like, it doesn't mean sometimes I don't want to come out and do this shit for you. It doesn't mean that. Because I'm fucking tired, bro. I want to live life too. I want to have fun. I want to roll down Pleasure Town as long as I fucking can. Like, why would I be any different? I'm the same. I'm you. You're me. We're the same. A little different. I was just bred different. I got a lot of pride and ego. Healthy pride and ego. I believe in who I am. I believe I'm the best of us. It wasn't an easy task. It wasn't easy. I could have been beat. I could have lost. But I'm me. IVEA. Me. It's not bragging or boasting. I'm me. This is not about comparing yourself to another human being or to anyone or to anything in existence. If I do that again, then I'm a fool. And I know that the love runs deep. I mean, trust me, you know I know. And I know that you really do got me. I'm not you. I'm not you. I'm me. So I'm writing the shit on notes. I just put my feelings into the. It's not good, it's not bad, it's not worse then. You're you, I'm me. I wanna steal your soul. There's none like me. And there's none like you. Trust me, they can't find you. I don't understand the comparing thing. I really don't. It just makes zero sense. Like, honestly, like, since I was little, like, in my mind, like, this is the scenario, because this is how I think. This is a scenario, like, you got beat, start comparing yourself, and then underneath that, like, it would go blank. It'd be like, that's pointless. I was like, that's fucking pointless, because there's so many different things that come into play. All infinite thing, everything comes into play. It's like, so how the fuck can you compare yourself to anybody? Like, it doesn't exist. Like, it doesn't fucking exist. Like, it makes me feel stupid to try and even justify comparing yourself to anyone. Like, it makes me feel dumb. Because that's how fucking stupid it is. You are your own. No one is like you, bro. And if you have a twin, they're still not fucking like you. They could choose. You could choose to be similar. But they're not you. What you got? Show me. What you got? I've had it all. I've done it all. I lived on the 3D. I lived with all the ass and titties in your face all the time. Love it. Have fun. Yeah, I've had whatever. All of it. I've done it all. Any kind of physical, whatever crap you want to say, like, I've done it all. I'm not impressed. Like, I'm not impressed. Like, but what is fucking real? Well, now, it's collabing with another human being. And in every aspect, that is what's real. That's what the max potential is. Creating together, using your max potential with somebody else's max potential. And what the fuck happens, bro? I got me, okay, like Super Saiyan times infinity, like whatever the... I don't even know. I don't even watch that stuff. I bought some art from some dude today. And he had some Dragon Ball Z ones and some Last Airbender ones. And I bought like 4 of them. They're fucking cool, man. And, but it's like that. I have the painting on the wall that is, you know, combined on power levels over 9,000. Like, I don't know where I get this inspiration from, but it's real. And, you know, the 9,000, I had this song, and it was a remix, and, like, it played that clip. Power levels over 9,000. And I remember my little brother heard it, and he loved it. He thought it was hilarious. I will say this. I always taught that kid new music. And it was so funny, because it's like, I've always just whipped people music. Man, I love whipping people music, because, like, it's something deeper than that. Like, every time that I get a song that I like, and it's like, we'll whip it to somebody, like, or it inspires me to send it to you. Like, it's a fucking reason. It's not, I'm not trying to be a creep. It's like, music helped me. Music teaches me. Music has stuff in it that helps you overcome things and whatever. Like, if you take it and harness it and treat it right, you accept it for what it is. Maybe worth something, you know? Accept it for what it is. You know, that's kind of why, like, I've had this... I mean, I still dip tobacco, but I love it. I need to come up with something better. I have before. I need a better quality of a product in order to create what I want to create. But, let's see where I could do it, and it would only be beneficial. Being that it's a habit that I created, there's always ways around it. There's always ways around it. I don't know where I was going with this. I don't even know how long this talk's been. Oh, it's almost 2 hours. Probably gotta kill it, man. Today was perfect, man. I appreciate everything. I appreciate the falling star, baby. I appreciate everything. I appreciate falling stars. I appreciate all of existence. I appreciate people, man. People pull you out of the fucking darkness. And, I'm nothing but dark. I just appreciate people, man. I appreciate art. I just appreciate being alive. Having time. You never know how long you got. And, just don't focus on that. Just enjoy what you got, man. It's a surprise. Your birthday every day. It's a new day. What are you gonna do with it? What are you gonna do with it? But yeah, I appreciate, man. I appreciate food, water, whatever. Roof over my head. Truck I'm sitting in. It all comes, like, it's crazy, man. Everything in life is beautiful. Like, humans created this. They came out of their minds, dude. Think about, like, 200 years ago, think there's an F-450 driving around. Looks badass. Pink. Lifted. Dually. Just a monster of a vehicle for no damn reason other than why the fuck not. Pink as hell. This is the greatest things in life for pink. Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know, flowers, whatever. To each his own. I'm glad that I've got me each his own. Everything I do is like a game. Like everything. It's so fun. Everything is fun. And so like, this was my logic a long time ago when I planned on having a pink truck. And it was like, it was kind of early in this stage of finding out who I am. And this is hilarious to me, but this is just how psycho I am. And when I do something, I do it completely. I'm like, cause there's no other reason why not to? Or just or whatever, until I feel comfortable of walking away from it. I don't know, man. But it's like, I was like, it's so funny because it's so stupid. It's so stupid. And like, I was like, Cody, I'm working on my confidence. I'm working on my confidence. Like, I got to do stuff that makes me confident. Subconsciously tricking my own self. And it's like, yeah, I told myself not to put my hands, you know, not to cross my hands over my chest to block people out. So instead, you put them behind you in a position that is non-threatening. And then you're kind of, you know, you open your chest and keep the hands behind your back. And I was like, so that helps with the self-confidence. I did it. I did it for a long time. And it worked. It fucking works. Genius. But then, so like during that time, I was like, you know what? I was like, I got to just do confident things. Like, you just have to do shit you don't want to do. And so I was just playing this game of doing shit I don't want to do. And it sucked. It sucked. Go ask like an 18-year-old girl out, like I felt fucking weird doing it, but I was like, I gotta at least do it. I gotta do shit I don't want to fucking do. And it's like, boom. But it's like a level up, pride up level there, like. And but I just did all kinds of stupid shit. I whatever, like anything, wear whatever, like, just who cares? Like, just build your confidence in who you are, and then be proud of what you're doing. And because why the fuck not? Like, you're cool. We're fine. And it's like, so, it's so stupid because now I look back at my life, I'm like, dude, there was no reason to never be confident in yourself. Like, ever. Like, yo, fucking you. Like, it doesn't, you can't compare. Like, those systems aren't even in this world. Like, this is make them up bullshit. You can't compare humans. Impossible. Impossible. Man upstairs doesn't compare. It's different. I honestly can't even explain it to you, but.
It's
special. All part of him.
Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know what I'm saying? Yo. I'm glad that I got me a Pisces.
All part of him. So yeah, I was just like, I just kept saying, like, I'm gonna have a, like, that's in my brain. Like, my next truck is gonna be a pink truck no matter what. Like, it has to be. I done accepted it. That to work on my confidence, I gotta drive the biggest, pinkest, brightest, girl vehicle I possibly can bring, can have. Like, there's no way you're gonna think it's me when I have to tuck and roll my ass out of it because you can't see who's driving it. Like, it's everything I do is a game. And it literally involves no one but myself. Like, it's so fun. Because, like, I want to be the next version of me. And the next one. And the next one. And the next one. Because the better version I am, the better version my partner can be. Or she'll get from me, at least. She doesn't have to do anything, whatever. But, you know, it's like I would have to be the first. Is the thing. Like, I have to be the first. And that's a pride ego thing. However, in this basic understanding on the 3D, you cannot understand it. Because you can't compare.
Hey, yo, Pluto. You going brazen?
Just can't compare. So I appreciate everything. You know, I'm all these things I'm on. I am enough. I'm infinitely enough. I'm worthy. I'm abundant. I don't even know, man. I'm all these things. I'm love, I'm light, I'm dark, I'm power, I'm grace, I'm hope. I'm impressive. I'm magnificent. I'm texting bro like, yo, E-man text me back like Wagwan. I said, bro, after all the whole stages, I'm ready. I found the one. So are you, man. Girl. Dude, whatever. You are who you want to be. Like, you literally, you are whatever you want to be. Because you would do anything to do it. Doesn't have to make sense to me. If it makes sense to you, I guess it does. I don't know. Don't infringe on someone's free will. Your friends and someone's free will is gonna be a problem. Very simple rule. Not very hard. Not hard at all. Probably the easiest. At least it was for Cody. Makes sense. No one friends and someone's free will. Kept me on a straight and narrow. I guess. Something, I don't know. Probably not. Life is funny, dude. I'm hungry. And I saw something in the sky last night that was hilarious. And I don't know what to say. I truly don't know what to say. It's the weirdest thing I've ever seen in my life. I'm not gonna talk about it because it's weird, bro. But, like, as soon as I talk, like, that's what it did. And it was weird. I laughed, like, multiple times as they listened to my talk. Every single time it came up, because I knew I didn't tell you what it was. But I know what it was, and it freaks me out. It's weird. It's hilarious. But that was cool, man. Every day is cool. Every day I get to paint, man. Love it. Love life. Every day is exactly what it's supposed to be. Nothing more, nothing less. And if you can come to that understanding, dude, it makes things easier. Like, everything makes things easier. Like, the simpler you make your life, the easier it is. Because you quit comparing yourself. Because that doesn't fucking exist. Mahalo. Love y'all. Peace.
Yo, Pluto, you going brazen?
Yo, yo, yo. I
ain't never had a girl like this. Real to the core is real. And I can't talk about sex every day on the track, so I talk about the shit I feel. I might give you flowers and kisses, not just dick, and this shit is bro. I might pull up on a late night one, like slap on a movie and come, let's chill. I remember the day that I met you, no way could I ever forget that. I would go back home on a DLR train, just missing the fact you left, man. I'm texting bro like, yo, D-man text me back like Wagwan. I said, bro, after all the whole stages, I'm ready, I found the one. Fake accounts gonna talk their shit, why? Both of us be lit. And I don't really give a fuck about that, as long as a relationship is bliss. And I know that my baby humble, but I know that your temper's short. And I know that I hurt you one time, if I do that again, then I'm a fool. And I know that the love runs deep, trust me, you know I know. And I know that you really do got me, trust me, I know. Winter time is cold, it's cold. And I find it hard to express, so I'm writing the shit on notes. I just put my feelings into the music, that's the way that man know. I wanna steal your soul now, wah, I wanna steal your soul. I'ma hide you, huh, trust me, they can't find you. Man, I don't know what to do now, nah, man, I don't know what to do. Hold on, let me talk star signs. You know what I'm saying? Yo, yo. I'm glad that I got me a Pisces. With water you put me out and I keep you grounded. That's light B. I'm so glad that your mum do like me. Got the old school love like 90s. And God forbid if I ever go jail, then I know that my babe will write me. And I know it's your B-day soon. I got you in your B-day boo. I know when you're upset, trust me when I see straight through. We're having a minor dispute. You walk out the room and the shit's so rude. Do you know that we're stuck like glue? 4L could the girl my boo. Oh,